Now let us try to understand some disorders, chromosomal disorders. Now you know the chromosome consists of genes. Now the mutation that occurs within a chromosome, either it may happen that the chromosome number might change, that is if it is like a pair of chromosome may not separate. So what happens? Both the pair are going to the same gamete. So a gamete will have an extra chromosome, extra number of chromosomes. So what happens in that case, the individual that will form will have an extra chromosome. So that chromosome is going to affect the individual's morphology, genetics, everything. Now we are going to discuss, and the other type of mutation might happen in the DNA. So it may be due to a single point mutation. What I am talking about is genetic disorders. The first one that we are talking about here is the Mendelian. This is Mendelian disorder. Now what is a Mendelian disorder? In this there is the alteration or mutation of the single gene. So it is alteration or mutation of the single gene. Now we have done one example previously, that is sickle cell anemia. We have seen that in the beta structure, that is the beta, there are two in the hemoglobin, there are two polypeptide, two alpha polypeptide chain and two beta polypeptide chain. In one of the beta polypeptide chain, there is the sixth position, is there is a mutation happening, and because of that mutation the shape of the RBC changes. Now in this, if these types of mutation, point mutation, if this mutation happens, then what happens? The genes or the gametes which will be formed, they will all have these type of the same mutation. So the disorder or whatever the disease that is formed because of this disorder will be passed to the next generation. So that is why these are called genetic disorders, because the disorders are seen in the gene level. And the other one is known as chromosomal disorder. This is the first one, and the second one is chromosomal disorder. Now chromosomal disorder is where the number or the shape of the chromosome changes. It is either the number or the shape of the chromosome changes. This is also happening due to various mutation only. But this disorder, the chromosomal disorder, doesn't pass down to the next generation. It is seen that these are not happening during the meiosis, whereas these things are generally happening during the meiotic stages. So we will, under the Mendelian, we will discuss the hemophilia. What happens in a hemophilia? So the first example that I'm going to take here is, example is hemophilia. Now hemophilia is also known as the bleeder's disease. It is also known as the bleeder's disease. Now why is it called bleeder's disease? The word bleeder's disease, you can understand, you can guess a little bit, that is the person, if the person is having any cut, then what happens, their clotting time is reduced. That means it takes a lot of time for the person to the blood clotting to start. So what happens, this, there is a gene or the clotting factor, whenever we get a cut, a clotting factor is responsible for that clotting. Now that clotting factor, if it is not produced due to a mutation in the gene, then what will happen? time, the person is going to continuously bleed and it may be fatal for the person also. Now, this disease was first seen in royal family. So, it is also known as the royal disease. Royal doesn't mean it's something very good, but in a royal family, this was seen. So, what happens in this? This is a sex-linked recessive. This is a sex-linked recessive disorder. Now, sex-linked recessive disorder means the mutation is happening in the sex chromosomes. Sex chromosome means X and Y chromosome. If it is recessive, then normally we say it is in the X chromosome, especially the X chromosome. Now, being a recessive, we know the female has XX. Being recessive, it has to, if the person, a female is having this disease, then both the chromosomes, the mutation have to happen. That is in both X. So, in both the X, you will find the mutation. If it is in the male, then only in one, the male has only one X. So, it is having this X, and this X itself is going to show the disease. This is a very important point. Please remember this. Sex-linked recessive, or it is also known as X-linked disease. The X-linked diseases will be always shown in homozygous condition. Homozygous condition in females. In female, but in male, since one X is present, and if this X there is mutation, then the disease will be shown. Obviously, there is no chance of homozygosity here. Now, what is happening? Let us see. Let us take one case of a normal male and a carrier female. So, I am taking an incident where normal male and carrier female. Now, before I go, I would like to tell you something regarding pedigree. Pedigree chart is a chart which shows the passing down of a disease from one generation to another. In that chart, the circle is the female, the squares are the male, the line joining the circle and the male is the mating line. This is the mating line that we are talking about. It is this one. Then the offsprings are actually shown in this way. Suppose this is a male and a female with a vertical line. So, vertical line will show the offspring. Clear? Now, the number of offsprings formed, suppose if this is the mother and the father, and I have shown a daughter and the son. So here we can see there are two daughters and one son. She is the elder daughter, the younger daughter and the son. So the way they are born, the two daughters are born first and then came the son. In the same order these are shown. If a person is carrier, suppose it is a female, then half of the portion is shaded. And if it is a male, then what happens? Then also half of this is shaded. So this represents a carrier. If the entire female is affected, then it is completely shaded. If the entire male is affected, then also it is completely shaded. So we write this as affected. Is this clear? Now coming to our normal male and a carrier female. The male is normal. That means the affected gene, we generally represent the affected gene either by a letter or by any symbol. So we can hear, since it is hemophilia, a common, the gene is represented normally by XH. That is the affected gene. The normal male, that means the male doesn't have the disease, so he is going to have X and Y. This is his sex chromosome. The female is a carrier. The female is a carrier. So what will happen in this case? This is the male and the female is a carrier. X, X, and one of the X, that means in this region, one of the X chromosome is affected. Now what will be the genotype of the next generation? So it will be XX or it may be XXH. This is XY and this is XHY. Isn't it? So now let's see. These two are female. This one, this female. So this is a female. This is a female. This is the male. And this is also a male. This female, the first female that we have, these are the possibilities, isn't it? This female is absolutely normal. This female is absolutely normal, not affected. So what is happening? A normal female. This female is carrier. She is a carrier female. Now this male is again normal. A normal male. And this male is again affected. Affected male. Is it clear? Now, so what did we see? That if the male is normal and the female is a carrier, the female is a carrier and it is passing the gene to the male. Now, if it is, she is a carrier, all her female, that is all her daughters are not affected. In sex-linked recessive disorder, we have to remember this, the disease passes from the female to the, from the mother to the son. Now you can do on yourself another where you can take a affected father and a affected mother. You can do the cross on your own and we can discuss it later. If the father, if you are taking a father to be affected, you will find that all the daughters will definitely be carriers, because there is only, if you are taking this father and a mother, and if the mother is a carrier or whatever, the daughters will definitely be affected. So there are few things which have to be clearly understood before you can go through these types of process. First, try to understand what is a pedigree chart, that is the symbols that are used to express a pedigree chart. If we are having problem, we can discuss this in a separate meeting.